One, turn it up! Praise the Lord. We're so happy to gather here on this New Year's Eve night to celebrate the birth of a new year. Amen. And the Lord has a word for us today. And it's coming from 2 Peter, the 3rd chapter, verses 8 through 9. That's 2 Peter, 3rd chapter, verses 8 through 9. And I'm reading from the New Century Version. And it reads, "But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. To the Lord, one day is as a thousand years, and a thousand years is as one day. The Lord is not slow in doing what he promised, the way some people understand slowness. But God is being patient with you. He does not want anyone to be lost, but he wants all people to change their hearts and lives. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. To the Lord, one day is as a thousand years, and a thousand years is as one day." And our message this morning, this evening, is one day at a time. One day at a time. One day at a time. Make eye contact with someone in your midst and say, "One day at a time." Look in the mirror and say, "One day at a time." Now point to yourself and say, "One day at a time." Let us pray. Gracious Master and our God, here we are at the beginning of a brand new year. We thank you for kissing us good morning for 365 days in 2021. Thank you that your goodness and your mercy truly followed us this year. Now, God, we ask that you continue to order our steps and speak to our hearts. And I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart will be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Let the people of God say, amen. One thing 2020 and 2021 has taught us, if nothing else, is to take it one day at a time. We thought 2021 was going to be different from 2020 when we first experienced a worldwide global pandemic that many of us have never, ever experienced before. But by the end of 2020, with the knowledge that a race to create a vaccine was on the horizon in 2021, we were hopeful for the approaching new year to begin. And we began to breathe a little easier, knowing that the best was yet to come in 2021. That is, until it did not come. And we continue to find ourselves once again in the midst of a virus, even with a vaccine. But this time, we've witnessed vaccination hesitation and mass-defying people keeping the virus alive right down to the very end of 2021, with the COVID-19 Omicron variant leading the way. Somebody say, "Lord, have mercy." Along with national destructions, personal tragedies, family losses, business closures, senseless violence, and unthinkable behaviors, we proclaim that 2021 to be the year that was blank, blank, blank. We can all fill in the blank. Can I get an amen? Yet, as we begin to fully engage the concept to take it one day at a time, we did find some glimmer of laughter or joy and even hope sandwiched in between the year that was. A new presidential team was at the helm of our country. The justice system finally saw justice in the killing of a person of color. Graduations were held, marriages took place, babies were born, homes were purchased, even the economic stimulus package gave us what we did not have. A little financial cushion that helped us in a year when finances were low. Somebody say amen. Yes, we always want to celebrate every opportunity to be in the land of the living, but we must learn not to take this life for granted, but to take it one day at a time. The Bible declares that tomorrow is not promised to us. Yet unbelievers often dismiss this warning as something not to take too seriously because, after all, isn't that what retirement is for? Tomorrow? especially by those who are known to place their hope in the stock markets, in the economy, in bitcoins, or whatever new currency they believe will make their lives better in the future. Now, God is not a pessimistic God. He is a realist. And he is reminding all of us, believers or not, that life is in his hands and not in ours. That our future is in his hands and not in ours. And that what is to come is also in his hands and not in ours. The early Christians were beginning to murmur amongst themselves as a group had risen up about the promise made by Jesus that he was coming back soon, but was not going to happen. After all, they have been waiting a few years and he still has not returned. How long does it take to return back? He did say soon, didn't he? So Peter, the wayward disciple, now turned fierce defender of the faith, writes his second letters to the believers, as he said, to help their honest minds to remember. He said, I want you to think about the words of the holy prophet spoke in the past and remember the command our Lord and Savior gave us through our apostles. It is most important for you to understand that what will happen in the last days. People will laugh at you. They will live doing the evil things they want to do. They will say, Jesus promised to come again, but where is he? Our fathers have died, but the world continues the way it has been since it was made. But they do not want to remember what happened long ago. By the word of God, heaven and earth was made. And earth was made from water and with water. Then the world was flooded and destroyed with water. And that same word of God is keeping heaven and earth that we now have in order to be destroyed by fire. They are being kept from the judgment day and the destruction of all who are against God. But you, Peter is saying, but you, don't you forget this one thing, my friends. To the Lord, one day is as a thousand years, and a thousand years is as one day. Somebody say amen. The Lord is not slow in doing what he has promised, the way some people understand slowness. But God is being patient with you. He does not want anyone to be lost, but he wants all people to change their hearts and lives. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. The skies will disappear with a loud noise. Everything in them will be destroyed by fire, and the earth and everything in it will be exposed. In that way, everything will be exposed and destroyed. So what kind of people should you be? You should live holy lives and serve God as you wait for and look forward to the coming of the day of the Lord. Somebody say amen. Peter here is attempting to stop the murmuring and those who have the potential to stop believing in Jesus Christ because of what they see around them. Nothing had changed. Everything is still the same. We can say the same thing. Same problem, same pain, same poverty, same pandemic. And to let them know that our God, our Father, does not see time the way we see time. His time is not measured in 24 hours. His time is not measured in 60 minutes an hour. His time is not measured in 86,400,000 seconds a day. No, a day to God is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like one day. How many times does he have to tell us that his ways are not our ways, nor his thoughts are like our thoughts? And to all the residents in 2021, of the planet of earth, the Lord is not slow in his return. No, he's not. No, he is being merciful and kind as he is waiting until we as individuals get our act together and turn from our wicked ways and repent and seek his face. Well, I just heard somebody say, I've done that. I gave my life to Christ. I'm saved. What else can I do? Well, I'm here to let you know that he's waiting for more than just you. Somebody say amen. For remember, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall what? Not perish, but have everlasting life. Somebody say amen. He's waiting for the rest of the world to repent. Climate change, COVID, and crime is upon us, so we can repent and turn back unto the Lord. Violence and wickedness and evil is upon us, as the Lord waits for us to repent and turn back to him. Greed, manipulation, and self-righteousness is in our hearts as the Lord waits for us to repent and turn back to him. For the Lord is not slow in doing what he promised, the way some people understand slowness. But God is being patient with us, for he does not want anyone to be lost, but he wants all people to change their hearts and lives. Well, you might ask, how can this be done? By taking it one day at a time. Can I get a witness? Walking each day with him and not in the flesh. Take it one day at a time and let him govern our actions and our attitudes. Take it one day at a time and give him all of our sorrows and our struggles. Take it one day at a time and live with him and for him in a world that is slow in knowing him. Take it one day at a time, no matter what life throws at us, knowing that the Lord will catch it before it hits us. Somebody say amen. Thank you, Jesus. You know, many of us have heard the story about the man who was sizing up God in a conversation. He asked God, how long is a million years to you? And God replied, a million years is like a second to me. So then the man asked, so how much is $1 million to you? And God said, $1 million is like a penny. The man grinned and he said, could you spare a penny, God? And without missing a beat, God said, sure, just wait a second. Somebody say amen. God will bring about his promises to us, and he will not be slow in bringing it to pass, but it will come and at the appointed time as he has promised. Thank you, God, for your promises. But our assignment in the meantime is to take it one day at a time, walking and working and witnessing and welcoming each new day as an opportunity for our hearts to change and our lives to reflect his glory. So come on, 2022, as the Lord allows us to enter in. We don't know about the years ahead. We don't know from years, and we also know from years' experiences that resolutions do not work for us. Turn to somebody and say, resolutions don't work for me. They don't work for us. But we do know about the one who has the year in his hands. And with Jesus as our Savior, we will take it one day at a time. Trusting in him who will not leave us. Seeing his face every day he shines upon us. Taking his hand as he leads us on. Listening to his voice as he speaks to us. And opening our hearts as he calls our name. The Lord might not have promised us tomorrow, but I'm here to tell you that he has promised us to be good to us. For surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. Let the church say amen. Come on, 2022. We celebrate the opportunity to be in the land of the living as we walk with the Lord one day at a time. Somebody say amen. Amen. But there might be someone under the sound of my voice who is experiencing anxiety about this upcoming year. The Lord has an app for that, an application. He said, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and petition, make your request known unto him, and he will answer you. But the only way to fully embrace this truth is to invite Jesus Christ in your heart, because he has the power to wash away your fears and your anxieties and fill you with his spirit that will give you a peace that will be beyond your understanding. If you desire his peace, I want to invite you to repeat this prayer of salvation after me. Jesus, come into my heart and save my soul. Thank you for your promise that you will be with me in 2022 and beyond as I walk each day with you. In Jesus' name, amen. We are so happy if you gave your life to Christ today, tonight, and you just prayed that prayer of salvation. Please call the church. Leave us a message at 410-669-8739. Again, 410-669-8739. We here at Payne Memorial want to celebrate with you that you gave your life to Christ the last day of 2021. Somebody say amen. And now, as we prepare to welcome in 2022, let us get on our knees, if we are able, and join others in these prayers given by many on the eve of a new year. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you that throughout the season of life, there are endings and new beginnings. We bless your word that reminds us there is a time for every purpose under heaven. Thank you for helping us to make it through this difficult year. Thank you that you've carried us through the uncertainties of deep waters, through the flames of trials, and through the pain of hard losses. We are constantly aware of how much we need you, your grace, your strength, and your power working through us in difficult times. Fill us with your joy and the peace of your spirit. Direct our hearts and minds towards you. Thank you for your reminder that both in seasons of celebration and in seasons of brokenness, you are still with us. Thank you for your daily presence in our lives, that we can be assured your heart is turned towards us. Your eyes are over us, and your ears are open to our prayers. Thank you, Lord, that you surround us with favor as with a shield, and we are safe in your care. So God, give us grace to accept with serenity the things that cannot be changed, the courage to change the things that should be changed, and the wisdom to know the difference. Living one day at a time, enjoying one moment at a time, accepting hardship as a pathway to peace, taking as Jesus did, this sinful world as it is, not as we would have it, trusting that you will make all things right if we surrender to your will, so that we may be reasonably happy in this life and supremely happy with you forever in the next. In Jesus' name, amen. Rise, shine into the new year. 2022 is here, and we promise to take it one day at a time. This is Pastor A. Kishmar Lima, Payne Memorial, African Methodist Episcopal Church, where God reigns and people serve in Baltimore, Maryland, wishing you a very happy new year.